Ladies and gentlemen, welcome, welcome, welcome. My name is Ben, aka Try. Of course, I'm joined by Mr. Bleedies himself. We are here for, of course, another Game Espresso Heroes Open. I'm excited, Mr. Bleedies. It's been a little while. How you doing?
I'm doing absolutely fantastic, and I think it's been actually a month since the last tournament, you know, considering it is a monthly tournament. But man, am I excited. I'm seeing some really solid teams here today, and it's just been a really fun meta to cast so far. So I'm looking to see if anybody's going to shake things up today, or are we going to see some of the more same picks that we've been seeing recently?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm personally loving the meta as well. I think it gives a nice flavor of some of those double supports mixed with a couple double bruisers. Depending on who you get, of course, we've seen a little bit of Artanis Loves the last few weeks considering he got that buff on Tuesday. So I'm really hoping we're going to see some good games tonight. We do have a bunch of teams that I recognize too. Of course, we do have, you know, Mazma. We do have OG Venom. So a bunch of teams that are very familiar with the amateur scene. So, and then of course our free agents, which it's always interesting to see how well they do. So I'm in for. I think it's going to be a great day. Like I said, those niche picks though always just make the day a little bit more exciting.
Yeah, I mean, we already see Twitch chat already talking about a Murky, which, you know,
it's definitely been
a lot of fun, and I think I've had my share of crazy niche picks, though, as I've been casting Nexoramus, which is every Thursday, so it's our ARAM tournament for our random CS, and I've seen everything from Gazlo to Murky to even, you know, Tychus, who...
I love Tychus.
That was different. He had a little bit of a different past week with that bug going on, but thankfully Blizzard realized how broken that was, and they fixed that pretty quickly.
Yeah, I actually really like the place that Tychus is in myself. But anyway, we can get into theory crafting once we get into the teams, because otherwise I'll ramble for the next 3 hours. Real quick, guys, I want to let you know a few quick shortcuts for you guys in chat today. We do have the exclamation point bracket, which will let you get kind of a quick snapshot of what's going on with the bracket over in Battlefy, so feel free to use that as well throughout the day. We also have the exclamation point survey, which as of last time, you know, which turned out really well for us, which gave us a lot of really great feedback for the event, kind of helped us figure the time out a little bit better, made us, you know, work on a few things regarding the production, just a whole bunch of stuff. So feel free to use the exclamation point survey. It's a lot quicker this time too. I simplified it a lot down, so it should be much simpler for you all this time. We also have this time, if you want to do exclamation point RCS, which is, of course, the admins of this tournament today. You can go check out their Battlefy page, check out every tournament event that they are running. So feel free to do that as well, either for our players or people looking to kind of jump into the amateur scene. Yeah, RCS is definitely the powerhouse of the, you know, as far as helping all this function, doing all admin, you know, and you guys don't see them, you see us, but the admins do so much. I know, Bleedies, you're an admin for several tournaments as well. So just in general, they do so much for, so be sure to, you know, always, you know, tout to RCS's way, because they do so much work and it's always hidden behind the back end. So I do also want to give a big shout out to the sponsors for today, people that are helping make this tournament happen. Of course, RCS, which I mentioned already. We do have Match Arena, which is just the absolute fantastic site that it is, helping to fund give prize pools for these tournaments. Absolutely fantastic. And then, of course, we have Dark Panda Media, which I won't talk about much because, of course, I'm a little biased towards it because, you know, I'm one of the partnering owners of that media organization. But we provided all the graphics you see here today. Put a lot of work into these, so hope everyone likes them. Hope, you know, any overlays, yada yada, we did that. So, you know, very happy for the partnerships that we have for this tournament as well. So, very exciting.
Yeah, definitely very exciting. And man, it's absolutely so windy out there that it actually blew my front door open. So sorry I had to step away for a second, guys, but it's kind of crazy over here.
Hey, esports. It's esports,
esports,
man.
Right? There's always things that happen.
Alrighty, well, our brackets should be getting seated, guys, so, you know, it shouldn't be too long until we kind of get our first game going around. So, you know, so Mr. Bleeds, I have to ask, what if you had to have a most anticipated map today, what do you think it would be?
I would like Towers of Doom, because Towers of Doom, it's a really unpredictable map. It's the one where I see the most comebacks happen. As a matter of fact, when the last tournament that I casted, the team was down 17-1 at some point, and then they came back and won the entire thing. So it's a pretty crazy map. I know you probably have a different idea though. So I want to hear what you want to see.
Well, from a player's perspective, I play on an amateur team as well for context for everybody. But Towers of Doom, it could just be that my team struggles with it. That could be why. But the thing I don't like most about Towers of Doom is I don't like the game ending mechanic, frankly, and I know that a lot of people do like that the game can, you know, you know, kind of it provides that nice comeback mechanic, because there's always the ability for a team to go, like, you know, we have the games where someone's at one health and then it bounces all the way back. And that's all, you know, that's great and that's fantastic. And I absolutely love that the players are able to have that ability. But Towers of Doom for me is just, I love the ending. I love being like, they're going core, they're going core. And, you know, they're the back door. So, you know, it's a preference, but not a bad map by any stretch, but it's a pure preference. And as a caster, you know, it's probably my on the bottom end of the maps that I enjoy, but that's just me. I like a Battlefield of Eternity. I like the strategic direction that a lot of teams take when it comes to handling how they're going to handle the soak while also trying to do the immortal, how they handle the draft. As far as, you know, a lot of teams don't even think about the Tyrande, and then she pops into the draft and it becomes an absolute nightmare because she burns it so quickly with her Hunter's Mark. So it's, I love how teams choose to handle like strategy on a map like that, or even like Infernal Shrine. So
cough, speaking of draft,
Oh, we ready to go with our draft, sir?
I actually did send you the draft, so let me know if you got that.
I will get that going right now. Let me pull that up for you guys real quick right here. All right, here we go. Let's get that pulled up, and then I will go ahead and switch the screen over for you guys. It looks like they are getting ready to figure out the their map, it looks like. Okay, so as soon as we kind of get the map going, guys, I'll go ahead and switch it over to you. So our first game today, guys, is going to be between Mazma Esports and 40 Hands. Not Edward Scissorhands, which is the first thought that came to my mind when I saw that title. I'm like, what, isn't there a movie like that name in it? Oh, okay. So, but that's a blast from the past, and that's a really old Johnny Depp movie.